I am Sandra
and this is my resources and ICT exam.
Espero in digital and educational content the teacher might be able to establish connection between the knowledge he has about the subject matter as well as the strategy for its implementation according to the social personal context or the institution itself possesses, according to the TPACK reference framework. According to the demand of an evolutionary society in the technological field, the teacher needs to establish in his frame of reference the introduction of the technological element not as a support but as an instrument that can expand the acquisition of skill, making more efficient. This ability to introduce and adapt if the teacher performs it properly, the student may be able to apply it in another aspect of their life. Finally, the teacher needs to establish clear objectives in the application of this technological element, how it will affect the learning content. It is essential prior knowledge and a logistic perspective. It is necessary the development of each of the basic elements or framework in cohesion with each other, being aware of the introduction of the technological element as another part within it, in a cyclical contribution. Not like the erroneous conception of an isolated resource used as a complement, using it in the same function as a strategy and that only makes students pay more attention. In the daily planning of the activity, I must consider know how the knowledge will be affected with the educational strategy that perform it, and as the technological resource that uses facilitate this act. We can use a portfolio to draft the integrated development. For the design of this, it must be considered adaptation to the environment and a logistic property. Another action in doing our reflection on action, where we will be able to observe if the development that we designed previously had been well, if not, the possible ways to modify. We can carry out this action with the help of a diary of documentation. Other teachers can be influenced with my use. In the conclusion, I determine will affect in the critical design of the future activities depend on the effectively, changing, for example, the tool use or the distribution of the class. Continue expanding my learning about how I will include the use of online face-to-face formative course, especially setting in the digital competence for teachers, and then the use of the online tool, as it el portafolio de la competencia digital docente, that evaluates continuously my formation and the development of this competence in my labor. As teachers, we must be exploring and engaging our personal learning environment adapted to the continual social innovation, to adapt to change and demand. In this way, introduction of the element and technological knowledge is essential. Students obtain the necessary resources later that they can apply them with a high level of development in society, helping to develop as critical adults, with the capacity of all the resources fairly select what bring them the greatest benefit. If the teacher, we are not conscious of the need to evolve, not being able to stay in the limit we are already now, we are offering real training to the requirement that I fair need to increase my training and they need to develop real skills to the content. The field of knowledge can be expanded with interaction we had among other teachers. In group meeting for the elaboration of a common curriculum, where each of the teachers can be enriched with the contribution of other members, so that you can expand the range of tools to be used, that students will be able to receive this contribution once they have been taken into practice, as well as teachers to apply them critically according to the need of their student and available resource. Something cannot be applied without prior certification, although we always acquire the experience for the error. The teacher on action to increase his knowledge level who can motivate the search through technological portal or logical resource about the implementation of innovation in education. Other teachers can start this work on their own or through the resource, rather only about their possible implementation. We must reuse our framework to be able to, from the information received, transform it practically to the fulfillment of the objective. The content will not be stable. A new introduction can produce a condition of another, which we must take into account in the development. To develop effectively this competency, I will include in my play the use of the educative blog related to the development of technological evolution in class, and the use of technological platform YouTube, in order that I will be able to visualize real application in the classroom according not only receiving explicit information, but also possible difficulties and development. A fundamental aspect, we must develop the capacity to use technology to expand our relationship with the student, family and environment. We must be able to use the resource offered by the technological tool according to the evolutionary chain of societies and family structure, we are no longer have the ability to maintain a traditional way, as it is due to the lack of time of life change. A teacher not able to adapt and to change, we will lose the necessary aspect for the integral development of the student. The joint work with the families and their involvement in the activity of the center is essential. Technology can lift up all the necessary points so that every impediment that may appear solved by the traditional method in a changing society will not be productive. In daily actions such as quarterly meeting with parents, we can facilitate the work through tools like Skype, being able to reduce that they must move to the center. Other teachers can use the resource to receive talk of receiving to their student. with teacher expert, offering the necessary possible perspective of you in their personal life. The information they can provide will be affect the conception of the most specific needs that the student present in the epistemic design of the activities. Also, through the publication of both of the center blog, teachers can work cooperatively, achieving common or classroom-specific goals, while students can also maintain communication with the teacher outside the institution, allowing their needs to be more addressed. To continue developing this aspect, I will introduce the series of opinion of the expert about the development of apps like Sky, can offer in the field of education and explore about them, in addition to expand the functionality of the center on message channel, such as Telegram, to achieve the daily exchange of information about the student. TPAC is the conceptual framework which determines the system of three types of knowledge present in the learning environment that effectively link to each other will allow us to develop a complex educational practice adapted to the demand of a classroom in the 21st century. The first introduction to this concept is under the need to develop the technological knowledge as an element linked to educational practice, not in an isolated resource, a practical element in the practical plan we can carry out using it as a guide, making it easier for our decision to maintain the interrelationship between the three elements. Because although it's an obvious, in many cases the school rhythm or the set of tasks can prioritize one over another. First, it is essential to clarify and possess information about the content we are transmitting, adjusting it to the hierarchy's degrees range, to transmit this content with educational strategy are the most appropriate, and finally, according to the objective that we want to achieve, which type of technological tool will offer more productivity in its development. An example of application in the classroom. I will teach about the name of the river of Spain, but instead with a physical map, it will be the student couple who will work in cooperation, share on the internet the information, different photos, articles or link about one of them, which I will first point out. They will produce a publication on Padlet with one photo and a little explanation with the tarchar state. Later, with all the materials, we can create a virtual map, sorting them by their geographic situation. The use of robots in the classroom as a technological tool. It is a hardware system that allows programming through an ad introducing a set of commands, allowing the student to direct their movement, action, and sound. The main objective that it implies as teacher is to avoid its introduction as an element of entertainment, if not that it is a further consequence of its use, based on its linkage through the TPAC, being able to use it in this way in different subjects and content, as an element that expands the barrier of knowledge acquisition, applying each of its functionalities to what the content and strategy demands, outside of programming world itself. At the social level, its introduction into cooperative and dynamic learning will be positive. According to the provision of few units, it will be easier for everyone to get involved. At the same time, which allow us to work several fields at once, which if the teacher has carried out proper planning, students will be able to critically establish their own link between area of knowledge and facilitate their learning, being also part of our play. We will work practically the perimeter of the geometric figure of the square and the equilateral triangle, probably explain it theoretically. To do this, we will divide into a group of 5 students who will be given a robot and the total perimeter data of the figure. Through the robot, they must program every measure of each side to draw the figure, determining that every second of movement is equal to 10 cm in length in the figure. We will work on an opposite methodology. The concept of play defined by Jordi Adel, Linda Castañeda as the set of tools, source information, connection and activity that each person uses assiduously to learn. Therefore, it has a unique character. The development of technology has motivated its growth according to the connection and source of knowledge transmission that has increased. Even indirectly, when we don't have intern, we acquire experience and links with our previous knowledge. I can say that although it is a concept that we can represent it physically, it serves as a reflection on mental organization and criticism about how we obtain information, work and create with it, and at the same time the reciprocal action, observing and receiving it from others, are all exemplified in our play through the mean or resource we use to do so. We could say that the approach that has the creation of a play and the application that it can have in our teaching practice has the same similarity as the scene of Freud's Ether, where in this case the tears represent the final product that we have obtain as information or a final video. Instead, the rest represent the great core or an element that we are not aware that we have, and in this way we reflect it. We will work in this concept developing the typical playoff for classroom with other, so in my own set, we will be adding a participatory way of the element resource experience that gives the possibility to learn in the classroom, in a way that serves as a reflection and at the same time that clarifies them, being able to determine what objective we intend to expand with each other and link them. They will be able to add its functionality and apply it in other areas of their life. The use of augmented reality in the class would allow us through a software application to be able to work with a physical reality through the device. Without doing it through this mechanic, we would only visualize a virtual image. The element can have functionality in different subjects according to which it can be adapted to the content that we need. The normal functionality that it gives us in our class is determined by the additional information that can provide. Even in a didactical way, the student will be able to interact with it. By making correct use of it, the student will be able to work more easily, with aspects that other tools not clarify at the same grade. Therefore, we reduce time and increase productivity in the session. Being themselves who work with the tool, the executive is not only getting theoretical content, but also in connection with social values, a critical perspective on autonomy. That's it. We try not to stay in a superficial concept, but that we set to work with it. We also introduce it as a selected element, but that is cohesive with the specific demand of the activity according to the TPAC. The session will work the ecosystem of the AI, will provide different templates according to the number of ecosystems they need to know, and they, with a mobile device in group of 5 students, will work with the physical reality in which will appear specific information they need to discover with a didactic use of it. Orally, they will provide to the rest of group the characteristics that they have discovered and a reason of why they occur.
Focus on getting good grades to show others, not only one side. This is the problem. I will tell you that my work deserves more than a night, but the critical and analytical capacity that I had developed does keep me on an base now of the learning that it is one I have come to look for. Having a role gives me a different perspective of the world, without hesitation. I will say with being an analyst, being able to question your own world allow us to not stay in a superficial tone, if not have a metacognition view of it, being able to set new goal for us. But above all, the possibility of asking questions, subconsciously has a great influence and has helped me to expand the typical barriers of a memoristic education. For me, it was a challenge to be a facilitator. I do have human skills, but manages to revert it to a participatory leadership, which after all, I maintain my values and it is what I can apply in the future. From there, we can learn, and having the possibility to recite it or provide a learning. The practical use of augmented reality has allowed me to check the functionality it presents and how you can expand the knowledge framework of my student. In addition to doing the realization of the virtual comic, I discovered to make a list comic software, which allowed me to perform it effectively. And the double the theory of knowledge you have taught me and the experience of having worked with it is also part of my play. I have even discovered a concept for me and now such as creative common license and the need to work with free material to use. Another aspect that I have certainly included is the methodology you use it. Since I have been working in a practical way, has allowed me to check it effectively, as well as to expand the odd barrier of reflection and interrelationship of content, as well as a comprehensive development experience. We don't live in an individual community, but in a participatory culture center, so reconstruction is necessary. And finally, a CIG reference framework, which we apply in hypothetical content for the development of activity and allow me to have an open front on the student possibilities, without having done, we probably would not think of.